Hello again, my name's John, a retired cook from the northeast of England in the UK, and welcome to my latest cheese making video. And in this recipe, I'll be using this amazing mozzarella and ricotta cheese making kit from cheeseandyoghurtmaking.co.uk. And this is their homepage, but I'll leave a link directly to the kit page in the description box below the video. I'll be making the mozzarella cheese in this video and the ricotta in the next video. And in this one kit, there's enough authentic ingredients to make up to 10 batches. All you need to add is the milk. You can view the ingredients list and full written method for this recipe on the recipe page on the channel's website. I'll leave a link in the description under the video, or you can click on the eye icon top right of the screen to take you directly to the recipe page. Okay, let's get on with today's recipe. I quickly go through what's included in the kit. First, the all-important instruction and information booklet, containing ingredient measurements and full instructions. Next, it includes a top quality cheesecloth. The very important thermometer, which includes the pan clip. 100 grams of pure cheese salt. 100 grams of citric acid, very important in making mozzarella and ricotta cheese. And finally, 100 grams of powdered rennet. Now this rennet is also suitable for vegetarians. And there you go, that's the contents of the kit. Enough to make 10 large batches of mozzarella cheese. All you need to add is the milk. Always start any cheese recipe by sterilizing all your equipment. I like to use boiling water, but chemical sterilizing can also be used, such as bleaching or an antibacterial agent. Obviously, make sure any chemicals that are used are thoroughly rinsed off. Right, onto the milk. It's important to use the correct milk in making mozzarella. And the best milk to use is whole, unhomogenized milk. I like to use Guernsey or Jersey cow unhomogenized milk. The result is a rich, creamy coloured mozzarella. But any unhomogenized whole milk will give you great results. So I'll get my 4.5 litres or 1 imperial gallon of milk into the pan. For my UK viewers, there's a link to raw milk suppliers in the description box below the video. Once your milk's in the pan, lift it over to the stove. Once your pan's on the stove, clip your provided thermometer to the pan. I'm using my large dial thermometer so you can see it more clearly in the video. Time to add the citric acid. And it's the citric acid that makes the mozzarella stretchy. You can add it straight to the pan if you like and stir it in, but I like to dissolve it in 50 ml of filtered or bottled water first. Now give that a good stir for about 15 to 20 seconds. Don't stir the milk too vigorously, just slow and gentle. At this point you can mix up the rennet powder, and the same as the citric acid, dissolve it in 50 ml of filtered or bottled water. And like I said earlier, this rennet powder is suitable for vegetarians. Right, that'll sit there until I heat up the milk. And to heat up the milk, I simply turn on my gas hob to a medium to low flame and heat up the milk slowly to a target temperature of 32 degrees Celsius, that's 90 Fahrenheit. Stir the pot occasionally to distribute the heat evenly. Once you reach the target temperature, turn off the heat. If you're on an electric stove, remove the pan from the hob altogether. In real time, this should take around 7 to 10 minutes. Time to add the rennet. Pour it in as evenly as you can. And once again, gently stir for about 20 seconds. Now get the lid on the pan and set your timer for 15 minutes. The recipe in the booklet says 10 to 20 minutes, so 15 is bang in the middle of that. Okay, time's up. Now you can test whether the curd is set. Take a thin, long-bladed knife or offset spatula, dip it into the curd, and if it comes out clean, it's ready to cut. And as you can see, mine's coming out clean. Now using your curd cutter, make a series of cuts one way at around 2.5 centimetres, that's an inch wide, across the pan. Then the same perpendicular to the first cuts. Now cover the pan again and let the curds rest or heal for 5 minutes. Okay, time's up on that rest period. Now it's time to cook the curds. Get your thermometer back on the pan and turn the heat back onto low to medium again. And now you need to slowly bring the temperature up to 41 degrees Celsius, that's 105 Fahrenheit. To keep the temperature evenly distributed, slowly stir the curds as it heats up. Cut any of the larger curds down to 1-inch squares as you go. They'll all end up massing together as you go anyway. But the key is to gently stir. Once you reach the target temperature, turn off the heat. And once again, this took around 10 minutes in real time. Now it's time to strain the curds. Place a colander or sieve in a bowl and line it with your cheesecloth. Right, using a spider strainer like this one or a slotted spoon, transfer the curds over to the cheesecloth. Let as much whey as you can drain back into the pan. Once you have all the curds in the colander, allow them to drain for 5 minutes, periodically tipping the excess whey back into the pan. Okay, on to the last step, and that's the heat and stretch phase. You have two choices how to do this, using the microwave or heating up the whey. I'm using the microwave, but if you want to use the hot whey method, just follow the instructions in the booklet. Once you've tipped out and drained the curd from the cheesecloth, get it into the microwave on full power for 1 minute. Now this gets pretty hot from here, so you'll need to wear rubber gloves. After that first minute in the microwave, drain and start to gently fold and stretch the cheese. Try not to fold it too much though, this could result in tough mozzarella. Drain any excess whey again and get it back into the microwave and set it away for 30 seconds this time. After the 30 seconds, once again, fold, stretch and drain. Right, now get it back into the microwave for 10 seconds and this will be the final one. Once it comes out, drain off any excess whey, and now's the time to add your salt. Sprinkle the salt over the cheese, now fold it and stretch it again until the salt is all mixed in. At this point you'll need to get ready a bowl of cold water with ice cubes in. Right, almost done. Now you can break off pieces of the mozzarella and roll them into smooth balls as shown. Once you complete each one, get them straight into the ice water. You should end up with about 3 or 4. Leave them in the ice water for about 10 minutes until they set. If you feel the mozzarella starting to cool down a bit and getting a bit more difficult to fold, pop it back in the microwave for a further 10 seconds and it'll magically become soft and supple again. I like to store mine individually in plastic bags with a little whey, and these should stay fresh in your fridge for up to a week. Time for a taste. And as you can see, these mozzarella balls are soft, moist, creamy and absolutely delicious. And what's even better, you've made them yourself. And here's just one serving suggestion. Homemade mozzarella, fresh tomatoes with crispy lettuce and basil leaves, salt, black pepper and olive oil. And that's one refreshing and delicious lunch any day of the week. So you can impress your family and friends with this amazing mozzarella and ricotta cheese kit from those nice people at Cheese and Yogurt Making. And I'm not just blindly saying that because I'm promoting the product for them. They are very good personal friends of mine and they know the home cheese making business inside out. So there you go, and I really hope you give this kit a try. Once you make this mozzarella, I'm absolutely certain you'll get a massive thumbs up from everyone. Well, thank you again for watching. Please like, share, comment and subscribe by hitting the circle above. If you do subscribe, activate the bell icon next to the subscribe button on my channel page. And by doing that, you'll be automatically notified every time I upload a new video. And in the meantime, here's a few of my other videos and playlists that you may want to watch. So, until the next time, be safe in your kitchen, and bye for now.